Although his life was abruptly cut short at the tender age of 24, James Dean left a huge impact on the film industry, becoming one of the most influential actors of all time and nothing short of a cultural icon. The man was really talented and had a unique style of acting that made all of his characters interesting as well as endlessly cool. Today I'll be ranking all of his films from worst to best, and when I say his films, I'm referring to the three films that he had prominent roles in. None of them are actually bad, but for the sake of the title, James Dean's worst film is Giant, released in 1956, a bit over a year after his death. The plot follows the quickly married couple, Leslie and Jordan Benedict, as they run a ranch and raise a family in Texas. Trust me, it's a lot more interesting than it sounds. The movie had quite the star-studded cast, with Hollywood heavyweights Elizabeth Taylor and Rock Hudson playing the lead couple. Just like the two upcoming films, this movie is really good. It's often lauded for its amazing cinematography, set design, and makeup. But in my opinion, where the movie really shines is in the chemistry of Elizabeth Taylor and Rock Hudson. James Dean did a great job with his performance as the young Jet Rink, but when it came to the older, heavier set, alcoholic Jet Rink, it went a little downhill. His performance isn't the movie's biggest problem, though. The biggest problem is the movie's almost 3.5 hour long runtime. Granted, there's enough going on in each hour to keep it interesting, but it was still rough getting through that first watch. Dean's second best film is the 1955 drama East of Eden, the only one of his three films to be released during his lifetime. James Dean stars as Caleb Trask, a young loner who, while seeking his own identity, tries to gain the love and respect of his father, who only shows affection to his brother Aaron, thus retelling the story of Cain and Abel. The reason why I put this above Giant is not only because of the shorter runtime, but also because it shows James Dean in his element, delivering a withdrawn, sometimes over-the-top, but always captivating performance. The entire cast does a great job, but the movie is heavily reliant on Dean's larger-than-life performance. That's not a bad thing, I'm just saying that it's very noticeable. Finally, as you might have guessed, James Dean's best film is the 1955 classic, Rebel Without a Cause. The film follows three teenagers who are going through problems in their respective homes. They bond over their struggles and throughout the film help each other to grow. I don't have time to fully explain how great this film is, but just know that after it came out, nothing was the same. James Dean delivers one of the coolest and best performances in film history. Unlike East of Eden, he's matched with equally amazing performances from Natalie Wood and Sal Mineo. Almost every scene in this film is iconic, and it truly is one of those you've got to watch it to understand situations. Which is why, without a doubt, Rebel Without a Cause is the best James Dean film. In conclusion, all three of these films are great. No matter if you choose the worst or the best one, you'll be treated to a good time. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to know when I upload next. This has been Andre Darius, and I'll see you all next time. God bless.